Let's talk about how to make the best use of your time. And even if you are aware of this topic of law of attraction, or say you are reading some prolific writers or some successful people, and upon which you have initiated some of those the thought processes and are working on it, but literally you still see that you have reached to a point whereupon you no longer is able to do things based on your own very self. Why is it happening, and why are you just getting deluded and is sometimes getting dissociated with your own sexual aura, getting deduced of how you actually want yourself, but you still have those natural tendencies are coming whereupon you see yourself, your old self, say a funny spirits are still popping up in your heads, or literally sometimes you go overboard, throw yourself to the overboard, say your superego is activated. And how you can cut it all out? Literally what happens is it that we haven't yet programmed our very self peacefully, and that's where we are all making a mistake. And why is it so? Just think it again. Someone has write something based on his past experiences, and he told XYZ would be the perfect reason to become an entrepreneur, to do things which may seem an obsolete to the society. Now you want to prove your own very worthiness in order to challenge the society. That's where you are all stopped at some point, and you want to move further. And quite commonly, everybody has told it that even after first success, for the next success, we have to build more discipline. Plus, we have to build more input in order to get the result, say 10 times more input to get some specific result or an output whereupon you are seeing yourself on the step growth process. But literally, how do we make this mistake that someone else's thought are not going to support your own personal goals and your personal challenges? And literally, we all follow this law of attraction topic, its principle, where we see that it is us who is responsible for everything that is working and acting around, because only your emotion is a unit, or say a measuring device, on which how you are able to assess everything around you, or else there no longer be any measurement standards that you can carry on. And that's where you have to find it out. And when you find it out, what next you should have to possibly do? First thing is it, even if there are several mistakes that you have done, or several dull parts from your past are still coming in front of you, are nothing but a complete illusion from the past. And people who do not like you, or maybe some new obstacles, or say new people are coming, they only want you to letting you be on this gradual scale of habitual step taken. They only want you to see that you are gradually taking his or her steps, which is not going to reflect their shortcomings or their very grandiosity, which they can let you be part of their own journey. Because sometimes no one can allow you to have business with, no one can allow you to be friends with, no one can allow you to be a part of your plan or project, the goals that you have it. This is why and where you have to be careful about it. People may not going to accept it, especially the ones who actually know you, have perceived you, your old image, because there is something about the vibration which they do not find it suitable with their memories or the patterns they have of yours in their heads. Same goes with the new business ideas, because people are very, 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 very clever, because this brain is quite clever. So this is how you can increase your own business, or maybe increase your own productivity, or say your own personal growth with this thing which I have narrated. Even if you find this video helpful, please like, share and subscribe this channel, Dungeon Motivations, for more videos. Thank you.